Listen, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Mount Zion, if you're happy to be in the house of the Lord, if you're happy to be among the living and not the dead, social media, if you're happy to be alive, put the activity and use of your limbs. Go ahead and give God some praise. Oh, come on, hop those horns. Put your hand real hard on the horn. And let the world know. We got another yes in our spirit this morning. Anybody got another yes in your spirit?
Yes.
I said, does anybody got another yes in your spirit?
Yes. I got another yes, Lord.
Thank you.
He's a That's why we lift up our hands. That's why we worship the way we worship. I don't know who I'm talking to, but you was on your last line, and right now the time for you to give God an unexpected praise. Because He is a great God. Songs, but I just want you to worship with me. Liberal. room, in your home, or sitting in your car. Chant that with us. Say, Lord, Lord, I
love you more than anything.
Sometimes God wants to hear from the fruit of your lips. Open up your mouth and sing your song. Lord, I
love you.
I don't care if you're toned up, deaf, and anybody else is about you and God right now. God wants to hear you. God wants to hear you, Lord. I love you. Right now, he don't want to hear about your problems. He don't want to hear about your situation. He just wants to hear his good love for him.
Love you more than anything.
Last time, and then we're going to set up a big shout of glory. Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you more than anything.
Send it up.
Yes.
Come on, Mount Zion, send it up.
Hallelujah.
Facebook Live, send it up. Every steward, every trustee, every soul that is thankful for what God has done for them. Send out your glory. Come on, praise team. Open up your mouth, lift up your hands. Send it up right here. Send it up right here.
Just so grateful for this opportunity to come in the parking lot, to come into your home, to come into your place of employment, wherever you may be on this morning. We bring you greetings from Mount Zion AME Church in Goose Creek, South Carolina. I'm Reverend Clinton J. McPherson, the proud pastor of this church, and we just give thanks unto the Lord for another day's journey. Amen. Let's make some noise in this place as we just tell the Lord, thank you. Your mercy, we come now with thanksgiving in our hearts. We thank you, dear God, for all that you have done. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for what you are doing right now. We thank you, dear God, what we trust, believe, and know that you are going to do. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for safe travel and mercy for our family members who are traveling to be with us here for this holiday season, and for family members that are traveling from here. We thank you, dear God, for allowing us to assemble once again, Heavenly Father, to sing your sweet songs of Zion, to lift up your holy and righteous word. We just thank you, dear God. Thank you for another opportunity, Heavenly Father, to come together on one accord. Lift up those in the hour of bereavement. Lift up those that are sick and shut in. Lifting up those, dear God, that do not know where the next meal is coming from. Those that do not have a roof over their head. Heavenly Father, allow us to continue to be blessed so we can be a blessing unto others.
Yes.
Heavenly Father, we just want to say thank you. Thank you for your grace and thank you for your mercy and thank you for your steadfast love, dear God. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for helping us to make up in our mind to run on and see what the end is going to be.
Yes.
Continue to allow our light to shine brightly. We love you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, and we claim victory in the name of Jesus. Amen. Our scripture for today comes from 1 Thessalonians. 1 Thessalonians, the 5th chapter, and beginning at verse 15. 1 Thessalonians, the 5th chapter, verse 15 says, make sure no one repays a wrong with a wrong, but always pursue the good for each other and everyone else. Rejoice always. Pray continually. Give thanks in every situation.
Yes.
because this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
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 Our dynamic, our outstanding praise and worship team will come and lead us in song. Amen. Let's make some noise as they come. Let's make some noise as they come. Let's make some noise as they come. Let's make some noise as they come.
Thank you.
15 through 18 says, make sure no one repays a wrong with a wrong, but always pursue the good for each other and everyone else. Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in every situation, because this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. We come this morning, Sunday, November 22nd of 2022, the week of Thanksgiving. We come to lift up, oh, give thanks. Oh, give thanks. My brothers and my sisters, before we draw near to the table, before we stuff ourselves to sleep, before we hide a plate for later, before we run our pressure up, before we run our sugar up, and before we mess around and trigger our gout, can we pause to tell the Lord, thank you? Can we take a moment to show the Lord that we are grateful? And can we take some time to acknowledge that everything that we receive, we don't deserve, but we are so thankful and we are so grateful unto God for looking beyond our faults and forgiving our sins and excusing our shortcomings and still supplying all of our needs. Y'all talk to me in here. Oh, give thanks. Can we humble ourselves and say, thank you, Lord? Having a conversation earlier this week, and somebody said that she thanks the Lord because God sees the needs before we even ask. Amen. Isn't that something to serve a God who knows all about us, to serve a God that created us, to serve a God that will give us more than what we ever could ask for before we even ask for it? Let us give thanks. And my brothers and my sisters, the reality is we receive so many blessings. We receive so many things. We receive so much goodness from God that we don't even know what to do with it. We oftentimes take it for granted. But I stop by to encourage you that in all that we do, give thanks unto the Lord. Even in our times of chaos, and even in our times of adversity, in those times when God is stretching us beyond our limits, we ought to still give thanks. We ought to still see the positive even out of the negative. We ought to trust and believe that because God has brought us to this place, that God is still working on us and God is still working through us. And for that, we ought to say thank you. Even in our darkest moments, God will still provide the necessary light for us to see our way through. And so as we look at the text today, the writer is talking to the Thessalonians about the day of the coming of the Lord. And my brothers and my sisters, I believe that we have been to enough wakes and we've been to enough viewings and we've been to enough funerals to understand that one of these days we shall meet the Lord. Amen. And so the writer is encouraging everybody to be ready. The writer is encouraging everyone to get your house in order. Don't repay a wrong for a wrong. And so in this season of Thanksgiving, if you know of someone who is hungry, my brothers and my sisters, you know what to do. If you know someone that is down and out, my brothers and my sisters, you know what to do. If you know someone that is in need of a helping hand, you know what to do. Because the reality is, the way that we continue to be blessed is that we take the blessing that God has given unto us, and we don't put it it in our pocket. We don't hide it behind our back. We don't put it up on the top shelf. But we figure out how we can take that blessing and be a blessing on to someone else. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. We don't have to wait until Thanksgiving to be thankful.
That's right.
The text says that we need to be thankful for everything. I know we don't eat just on Thanksgiving. We don't just wake up on Thanksgiving.
Right.
So every time we draw near to the table, we ought to say thank you. When the Lord wakes us up in the morning, we ought to say thank you. When the Lord brings us out of something that we put ourselves in, we ought to say thank you. And I know I've got some witnesses in this place that have so much to be thankful for. The songwriter says that I cannot tell it all. But Mount Zion, I stopped by this morning to say I thank you, Lord, for one more day. I dropped by this morning to say I thank you, Lord, for my family. I dropped by this morning to say I thank you, Lord, for my friends. I even stopped by to say I thank you, Lord, for my enemies. Because what I wanted to do to them, I no longer have to do those things, Lord, because you stepped up and you stepped in and said, God, I want to say thankful. Thank you. Anybody in here thankful for the name of Jesus? Anybody want to declare thanks unto the Lord? Anybody understand that we give the Lord thanks because God has been so good? Give the Lord thanks because the Lord saved our soul. Give the Lord thanks for being God and being God all by himself. We stop by to say, thank you, Lord. We've seen too much Mount Zion. We've survived too much Mount Zion. We've been through too much not to say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for all that you've done for me. I need y'all to go ahead and tell the Lord thank you. I don't know what you have to tell the Lord thank you for, but go ahead and tell the Lord thank you. Tell the Lord thank you for a roof over your head. Tell the Lord thank you for clothes on your back. The old school church would say, thank you, Lord, for a reasonable portion of health. Thank you, Lord, for everything. The text says that we ought to thank the Lord for everything, because it is the will, it's the will of our Father. Isn't that something? If we serve a God that lets us know that I'm going to bless you, and I'm going to bless you, and I'm going to bless you, and I look for you to say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. Y'all remember Sanford and Son, Fred G. Sanford, but oftentimes say, oh Lord, this is the big one. I wonder if on Thanksgiving week I've got somebody on How Hall Road with a big one for the Lord. I've got a big thank you, Jesus. I've got a big hallelujah. I've got a big yes, Lord. I've got another yes, Lord, in my soul. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you, Lord, for everything. I thank you, Lord, for my tears. I thank you, Lord, for my good days. I thank you, Lord, for my bad days. I wonder, oh, I wonder, before we draw near to the table, before we pile up our plate, before we eat and we drink more than we can before somebody has to roll us away from the table. Right now, do we have a thank you, Lord? I just want to thank her, you, Lord. In case you're wondering why Thanksgiving is on my heart, the God I serve, he saved my soul. The God I serve gave me another chance. The God I serve picked me up. Eat a whole pie. Talking about myself here now. Before we hide that plate for later, we got to tell the Lord, thank you.
Amen.
Yes.
God has been so good to us.
Yes.
Even in the midst of a pandemic,
yes.
God has allowed us to assemble once more and again.
Yes,
and so we come to this time in our worship experience that we dare not take for granted. It could be you, but there are some families who have loved ones in the hospital,
yes.
Have loved ones on their bed of affliction. And because of what's going on in our world, we can't get together the way we would like to. And so while we have this opportunity to give thanks unto the Lord, we need to go ahead and do it.
Amen.
And the text today explained that when we give thanks unto God, we are doing what is pleasing in the sight of God. We are operating in the will of God. Isn't that something?
Yes.
That when we give thanks, we are doing exactly what God wants us to do.
Yes.
So as the praise and worship team begins to sing, wherever you are, you have an opportunity to give thanks unto the Lord. And what greater way to do it than to give your life unto Christ. And for those of you that stand in the need of prayer, this is your opportunity, wherever you may be, to turn it over to the Lord. Anything still available after 12 is open to everyone. Amen. But I want to wish you and you and you and you and you and you and yours a happy and a safe and an enjoyable Thanksgiving. Amen. Because yes. I am going to enjoy myself. I'll tell you that right now. But we just thank the Lord. Such a beautiful day.
Yes, it is. Yes,
such
it
a beautiful is. Day. Such a beautiful day. Such a beautiful yes. day. And we say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We're getting out of here. Now, Zion style. Amen.
Amen.
May God bless you and may God keep you. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, Mount Zion. Oh, give thanks, eh?
Oh, give thanks unto,
unto
the Lord.
Oh,
for he is good.
Yes, he.
Yes, he is good.
Oh, give thanks, eh?
Oh, give thanks
unto,
unto the Lord.
Oh, he.
For he is good. Yes, he
do it again.
Is good. Thank you.